Do you have gossip in your office? Generally, gossip happens when people are not courageous enough to confront somebody with a problem they see, and they want to feel better about themselves being different than that person gossiped about. So instead of talking to the person, they go and talk to their friend. One of the core indicators of gossip in an organization is distance. You used to have a close relationship with somebody, but now they're kind of standoffish. They're a little far away. There's a good chance that someone has been gossiping to that person about you, or you have been gossiping about that person to someone else. There's a scripture verse that says, "A whisperer separates intimate friends." And that really happens with gossip. The other thing that happens with gossip is suspicion. Now someone gossips in my ear and I start looking at that person in a negative light. If you're a leader of an organization, it's not likely that you're a gossiper because gossipers don't really grow in leadership. The problem for a leader is, what do I do when someone is gossiping to me? Here are three tools that you can use to turn that gossip around. The first is to tell that person that you have made a promise not to gossip about others. That will build trust with the individual who's gossiping to you to where they know they're not going to get gossiped about, but it'll also challenge them to stop gossiping. The second tool that's a little bit more direct but really works is to set up a meeting with the gossiper and the person gossiped about. "Oh, you heard that Johnny did this? Well, let's go talk to Johnny. I'll set up a meeting. You be there. We'll be sure to talk about it." That'll stop gossip in its tracks pretty quick. And finally, just like negative sarcasm in an organization, have a zero tolerance policy for gossip. Gossip will destroy your environment, so don't allow it to grow. Thanks for watching this video about how to remove the culture killer of gossip in your organization.